the FIA World Endurance Championship. Following the regulations of the 24 Hours of Le Mans, the World Endurance Championship, known as the WEC, has become one of the most respected racing series in the world in only 2 years. The reasons for its success are as simple as they are numerous. GT race cars wheel-to-wheel with Le Mans prototypes, amateur drivers next to professionals, petrol engines up against diesel engines, hybrid concepts competing with conventional drive systems. All that carried out on 8 of the most spectacular racetracks in the world, spread out over 4 continents, a unique combination in automotive racing. Porsche entered the World Endurance Championship in 2014. The manufacturer from Zuffenhausen sent 2 LMP1 race cars into the race against Toyota and the 2-time championship winner Audi. So the duel for the LMP1 crown became a 3-way battle in which each manufacturer would deploy its own vehicle concept. Efficiency was in demand. And so the manufacturers started the season in different hybrid engine power classes depending on their engine model. Once again, the home of British motor racing, the renowned Silverstone Circuit, opened its gates to welcome the WEC for the first race of the season in typical British fashion. Heavy rains were responsible for a lot of slides and collisions, and Audi wasn't spared. Though both drivers were unharmed, the manufacturer from Ingolstadt closed its pit doors at 4:15 p.m. local time. Toyota had an excellent start to the season with a 1-2 victory ahead of Porsche and entered the second race of the season in Belgium, leading in the drivers' and manufacturers' championship ranking. The Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps. The course of the track is unique in motorsports, and it's not known around the world as the Ardennes roller coaster for nothing. The teams traditionally use the 6-hour race in Belgium as a dress rehearsal and setup to the following legendary race, the 24 Hours of Le Mans. After a qualifying with constantly changing weather conditions, the cars entered an extremely turbulent 6-hour race. The manufacturer from Ingolstadt entered a third car to its roster for this race, just as it would for the next race in Le Mans. The Ardennes roller coaster illustrated the power of the LMP1 race cars this year and offered the countless fans overtaking maneuvers and continuous action at Spa-Francorchamps. The team of Buemi, Davidson, and Lapierre also won the Le Mans dress rehearsal and extended their lead in the Drivers' Championship ranking. Le Mans, the most famous and prestigious endurance race in the world. Once again, the French town attracted thousands of motorsports enthusiasts to experience the unique atmosphere and scores of VIPs both on and off the track. It was obvious that Porsche would be the center of attention as the Le Mans record holder returned after a 16-year break. And Audi, the dominating force of the classic endurance race over the past decade and a half, with last year's winning car driven by Loic Duval and Le Mans 9-time record winner Tom Christensen, were also in the spotlight. But the world champion and defending champion started the 82nd edition of the classic 24-hour race with a heavy burden. Loic Duval crashed in the pre-practice session, but much to the relief of all the drivers, he was able to climb out of his car unharmed. But the race was over for last year's winner before it even began. Replacement driver Marc Genet took his place. Toyota's Kazuki Nakajima, Stefan Sarrazin, and Alex Wirtz started the race in pole position. The number 8 championship leader was sandwiched between two Porsches, while Audi started the race in positions 5, 6, and 7 with a really good chance of catching up. But then the rain gods had a hand in the race, which resulted in the number 3 car prematurely ending the race through no fault of its own. But the manufacturer from Ingolstadt didn't let that distract them. They continued to battle for position as if advertising the glory of motorsports and ended with a 1-2 victory on the Saat. Marcel Fessler, André Lotterer, and Benoit Trelier claimed Audi's 13th victory out of 16 races in Le Mans, as well as a personal hat trick.
Yeah, I can't be happier, you know, share this moment with my teammates and the whole team. It's just fantastic to win it for a third time.
Audi claimed a lot of ground in the manufacturer's ranking with the double scoring of points in Le Mans, but Toyota still had a slight lead heading to the first overseas race in Austin, USA. The 6-hour race started under blue skies and bright sunshine. 90 minutes into the race, heavy rainfall resulted in a number of cars dropping out, which even the best rain tires couldn't prevent. Even the leading Toyota up to that point was affected. The rain severely influenced the race and resulted in a number of cars dropping out, and the race was consequently interrupted. 45 minutes later, the race resumed behind the safety car with Audi in the lead. Audi succeeded in turning the tide at the midpoint of the season and took the lead from Toyota in the manufacturer's ranking. Countless fans once again flooded the Fuji International Speedway at the foot of Japan's largest mountain, the Fujisan. Toyota was strong for its home race right from the beginning, and after another victory, the Japanese reclaimed the lead from Audi in the manufacturer's ranking. The Shanghai International Circuit, with the longest curve in motorsports, welcomed the WEC for the third-to-last race of the season, which due to both Toyota's early pit stops during a safety car phase, set the course to victory. Toyota extended its lead in the manufacturer and driver's ranking with another double victory. Porsche made it to the podium, but despite its pole position, wasn't able to win its first race of the season.
On our way, guys. Great job, Seb, as well.
Gün dolandı dalı taşı, dinmiyor gözümün yaşı.
The Kingdom of Bahrain welcomed the WEC with its own characteristically oriental flair. Formula One star Fernando Alonso watched as the drivers awaited the start of the race. After approximately 1 hour and 45 minutes into the race, as day turned to night, the leading number 8 Toyota was forced into the pit for a lengthy repair due to problems with the alternators. About 75 minutes before the checkered flag, both Audi race cars were burning up the track with the 2 fastest lap times. But ultimately, it wasn't enough to get the manufacturer from Ingolstadt up on the podium. Porsche came in second and third place, while Alexander Wirtz, Stefan Sarrazin, and Mike Conway claimed their first victory of the season. Sebastian Buemi and Anthony Davidson came in 11th place and claimed the world championship title in the driver's ranking at the next to last race. The overall victory in the manufacturer's ranking between Toyota and Audi would ultimately be decided at the final race in Sao Paulo. But the focus before the race wasn't on this upcoming decision, but rather it was clearly on Tom Christensen, the 9-time Le Mans winner and 2013 World Endurance Champion, who announced he'd be retiring from his impressive career shortly before the race began.
A few weeks ago it came to the point that I would like to do my last race with the knowledge that everyone would know it's my last race. I didn't want to keep it secret.
At the very latest, at 5:19 p.m. local time, 1 hour and 41 minutes until the checkered flag, all eyes were focused on Tom Christensen. That's when Mr. Le Mans climbed behind the wheel of the car currently in second place for the last time in his career. There was a moment of shock approximately 27 minutes before the end of the race. Mark Webber was embroiled in a serious collision, but luckily he and the Ferrari driver involved pulled through without any serious injuries. The remaining Porsche behind the safety car went on to win its first victory of the year. Toyota claimed victory in the manufacturer's ranking, but that still couldn't dampen the joy the significant race held for Audi with the third spot on the podium.
I'm the, if I dare say, the most proud person in the world today, the most happy person. It just proves that this is and was the perfect and right time for me to end my career. So it's a happy man returning home.
After the FIA WEC season finale, Tom Christensen happily hung his helmet up, but will remain with Audi as a consultant. Perhaps it's something that shouldn't be underestimated, because next year Sao Paulo will be replaced with the Nürburgring, and the battle for the endurance racing crown will start anew.